at it again with another video 3 weeks late, but as you can see, I'm in a new location. And as you can tell from the title of the video, we're talking about living alone at 18 tips. So take it from a person who has lived by herself in an apartment in Las Vegas for about a year. Almost left my lease early to move with roommates, but that fell through, which is another tip. Oh my gosh. All right, should I write these? I don't really have anything written down, but I feel like I should have it organized somehow. To preface, you know, maybe you're, you know, 17 years old, ready to be legal, your parents are talking at your throat, you know, maybe you're in an abusive household, or maybe you just want to do shit on your own time and you're trying to move out. Here's some things to note before you do this big ass step, because it really is, you might not think it is going into it, and yeah, you're gonna be like, yeah, I know you have to pay bills, but no, there is like so much more that goes into it, especially if you're living alone as a female. First tip that I can give you guys is to determine whether or not you actually need to move out. And yes, this may be like, okay, you think I didn't think this motherfucking through, but no, like, is it really about your well-being, or is it about you wanting to do shit on your own time and you just thinking, to do what I want to do, I gotta be alone? So bad. You have to determine whether you want mental stability or financial stability, especially if you're 18 or, you know, around that age, because there's a lot of bills that come into living alone. You may think it's just rent, utilities, maybe water, food, whatever, but no, you're gonna need renter's insurance, you're gonna need to pay, you're probably gonna have to need your own transportation if you're not living with your parents. You're probably gonna need insurance on that transportation. And then you're probably gonna need to pay your own health insurance, your own dental, because that's separate for whatever reason. And then you're probably gonna need to pay for your own recreational motherfucking day-to-day things. And then you gotta think about, fuck. You know, it took me about, I think it took me like 5 months to buy a vacuum and knives. Like, I lived in my apartment without a knife set, a pot set, and a vacuum when I had carpet for a while, just because I was so cheap. I already had to spend money on a table, a couch, a Swiffer, laundry detergent, paper towels, toilet paper, fucking condiments, seasoning, everything. And, you know, when you live at your grandma's house, all that shit come with it, you know? Another thing, I feel like another factor about living alone is that you have to think about your safety and who you're bringing around your space. In the sense that when they know you live alone, you're in a more vulnerable, you know, place. Because like, if you live with people, they'll know like, oh, somebody might always be home, or somebody might come home, whatever, whatever. But if somebody's watching you and they know you live alone, they only gotta look for you. They only gotta leave when you're not there, or, you know, follow you home to get in there, or whatever the fuck. So that's another thing to think about, especially if you live in like a city like me, Las Vegas, which has a really high human trafficking rate. I've had people follow me home. Ooh, I didn't tell my family about this. I've had people, well, a lot of stuff can, you know, a lot of stuff can happen. So you just gotta be careful. What else? And then another thing, I feel like when you're around people a lot, and maybe it was just me and I'm like a lonely person, even though I love my individual space, I love being alone, especially, yeah, it was fun like the first 6 months, but let me tell you, it'd be like, well, I don't really want to make food today because it's only me, or oh, I don't really want to, you know, take care of myself because I'm only gonna, you know, I'm gonna be here, and but like when I'm in a household with people, I feel like, you know, you kind of get yourself, you brush your teeth for other people, you make sure you smell good for other people, and maybe, oh, am I just saying I'm depressed? I don't know. but like, it's just, you know, it's good to have other human contact, point blank.
Like, I'm ready to move out, but then I save so much money, and then it's like the second month, and they don't have a couch because they didn't think that they're gonna spend that much right when they moved in. Like, move it in costs money. They think that it's just first, and then you just pay rent for the month, and then that's it. Like, you move in, like, no, you gotta pay for the deposit, you gotta pay for sometimes
yep. last month's rent. Oh, and babe. One of the other things, you need to have renter's history and credit before you even get into the motherfucking place. So if you don't got credit, you're gonna need 3 months rent up front. And that's it, you're not getting it back. It'll end up going towards your rent at the end of the year, but you're gonna need that shit up front. So if you don't got renter's history, you don't got credit, that's another step. Then you might need to get you a roommate or somebody else to sign for you or with you. Then you're responsible for their credit and a bunch of other shit, which is never a good feeling for another person. And you know, some people aren't ready to move out, you know, so some
that's
you could
the real truth.
Yeah, if you guys don't know, I'm on FaceTime with my friend Rihanna, and yeah, but yeah, I've had other people where it's gone past that and it's like, fuck, like they're messing up your money situation, they're messing up your credit, and it's like, you can't be, you know, it's already hard to be responsible for yourself, and then now you have to pick up the slack if somebody decides that they're gonna pick up and leave on you. So I've even had family do that, so don't trust. All I can say, make sure you I was about to reword it, but if you're gonna go into a rental agreement with anyone, make sure you trust that motherfucker, and make sure they trust you, because business and friends just don't mix. It just don't. And you may think, this is not business. Like, we're not selling shit here. No, y'all got contracts together. Yeah, money is involved. This is business. So what are other things? So we got, like, make sure you're financially stable. Make sure you're mentally stable. Make sure... Make sure, don't be bougie, okay? One thing that I learned too, living alone, don't be bougie. I'm a bougie bitch. If you know me, I'm a bougie bitch. But I wasn't always bougie, okay? I've actually always been cheap. But one thing about it was, I love Target. And living at home, I could shop at Target every time if I really wanted to. But, you know, you gotta, you know, shop at Walmart, okay? Shop at Food Max. Go to the dollar store. They have good ass cleaning supplies. Don't be thinking, oh, now that I'm living alone, I gotta cough up the coins for every little thing here and there. Nope. You feel me? Nobody knows what the difference between this toilet paper and that toilet paper for real. Yeah, maybe one's like cardboard and one.
Floor cleaner.
Yeah, you know, Fabuloso smells amazing. Okay. So, I guess not a lot of people are like that, but I definitely would want to always shop at Target every time I go grocery shopping.
Secondhand is your best friend.
Yes, Rihanna's tip. Secondhand shops are your best motherfucking friend. Facebook Marketplace, Mercari, Depop, OfferUp, all them hoes, Craigslist. You know, be a little sketch about it, but all those hoes are your favorite for secondhand furniture, all those housewives giving away, you know, shit for free even. You want to jump on that. So make sure you take advantage of all opportunities before you go to Target, before you go to Home Goods, yes. Even though they do sometimes got the deals. Home Goods.
Ross.
Yeah,
sometimes
Ross is
like
good too.
You can't shit for cheap, but you really want to make sure you do your research before you buy something like new like that.
Yeah.
So most likely Craigslist will have some shit similar that or like some shit that's from IKEA, same shit, it just fucking
for a little bit. Litter with tree. Also, living alone, you are gonna realize who your friends are. Low key, like if you decide to let somebody come into your space and they're leaving trash around, they're inviting people you don't know, giving them your address and all this, all that. You need to be very sacred about your space and make sure the people that you bring into it respect it the same as you, if not more. And yeah, you're gonna notice a lot of people just wanna hang with you and use your spot as a little party place because whatever reason. Yeah, so make sure, you know, whoever you're inviting over,
you for the shit that you could give them.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. And I'm spot. Well, not all the kids that fucking 18 years old, fucking 20 years old, kind of spot. So let's believe.
Right. Especially, yeah. Like, bro, my, not to brag or nothing, but like, my pool was 24 hours. My gym was 24 hours. We had a game room with a pool, actual yeah, pool. Perks. Hella perks. And motherfuckers definitely wanted to
want
come.
They want it. Right?
They wanted to come over and fuck shit up and just leave. So, you know, that ended real quick. If you're moving and you've ever moved anytime, you know that those moving costs add the fuck up. Boxes cost, packaging tape cost, movers cost, this and that gonna cost. So you know, you should bring your ass to Costco and ask for some free boxes, because that's another one. Another trick, let's say you got like clothes and you're packing it up. Let's say, right, you got clothes on a hanger. Get you a trash bag, and while it's still on the clothes hanger, fill up all your clothes at the bottom with the trash bag and scrunch, or I guess, you know, tie the trash bag up here. So that way you don't have to take anything off the hanger, and when you put it back wherever it needs to go, you just hang it and untie the trash bag. I guess, but moving out is fun. Like, don't let me ruin it for you, because moving out is lit. Like, I learned a lot about myself. I learned how much responsibility it actually is to run a household and keep shit right, because there'd be months where I would refuse to go grocery shopping out of pure laziness, and you know, that ain't healthy. Oh my gosh, but like, honestly, how are you guys? Because it's been a while, and I never really do sit down talk videos, because that requires a lot of like reevaluating afterwards, the editing process. But I have moved from my apartment back to my grandma's house. Well, I've never lived here before.
You didn't give your story on like how you moved out, like all that shit. Like, cause you're giving all these tips, but you're just like, oh yeah, I moved out. Like, no, you didn't say how or like.
I mean, like, what else is there? No. I don't know. Well, I guess in my apartment looking process, it's kind of conflicting or hard to explain, because I'm the type of person that wasn't really thinking about like placement or like how, like, I was just trying to move out, have it be the cheapest, have it be closest to my school and like what I needed. But that was pretty much it. I wasn't thinking about like what other places was around me, if it was gated, what the, you know, if when was this place built, the amenities. Because honestly, I'm a very like simple person. I was not, I'll insert some videos, but I was definitely living way too luxury for an 18-year-old. So I don't know in that. It was more like my grandma convinced me, because I needed to be in a safe neighborhood, which definitely helped for the people that I was around and things that I was doing. But yeah, definitely you wanna move in somewhere where it's been newly built up, because that'll be the cheapest when the rent is, because they're just trying to fill up places in that point. I moved in when my apartment complex was about 6 months old and it was only filled up about 30%. So you don't ask me about those tips, because I would have for surely been living on the east side if it was up to me. But yeah, I definitely want to give a big shout out and a big thank you to my grandma and Jasmine, because Jasmine put her name on the lease for me with my grandma, and they basically helped me through the interviewing process and all the paperwork and everything having to do with that, because otherwise I really would not have known how to approach and like insert myself and actually get a tour and everything like that. So yeah, accept help if you have it, because you are blessed to have it. And you know, don't, oh, I'm gonna move out and be on my own. No, if you can get some help, take it. They're gonna respect you more for that, because you know that life isn't always about, oh, I did this and only I could say I did this and no, you know, get over it. People need people. I definitely had that mindset of like, I just want to be on my own. I don't want to be dependent on anybody. And that kind of, you know, turn me out more money in the long run. And you know, I could have been, I could have been saving money. I was spending about $1,200 on rent every month, and about, I think, $25 on renter's insurance every month. And it was a really nice place. And if you know, you're from California, what you see in that video, or whatever you see in that video, is way more than you could ever get in California for that price. In California, you could probably get you a room with your toilet in the same one. Yeah, I think we pretty much covered everything, or everything I wanted to cover. I don't like how I'm saying that. If you guys have more questions, definitely drop that shit in the comments, and I'll do a part two. I don't know, I kind of want to update them. I got my roots smudged the other day at Paul Mitchell School in Henderson by Aaron. Shout out to you, Aaron. And I'm loving this color, yo. Like, I want to go lighter though for sure, and eventually be like a really nice, oh shit. If you guys enjoyed this video, let me know in the comments down below. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. I'll be replying back to that shit. But yeah, I'll see y'all next week, hopefully. See you next time. Maybe.